In this video, we're going to work a word problem involving differential equations. Okay, so let's suppose that we've got this beautiful lake up in the woods. We'll call it Lake Pristine. And Lake Pristine holds 50,000 cubic meters of water. Unfortunately, there's a factory nearby, and they had an industrial accident. And because of that accident, 10 tons of toxic waste got dumped into the lake. And it immediately dissolved into the lake. And for some reason, it's this stuff that dissolves very easily, and it's always going to be uniformly distributed over the lake. Now, of course, every day, a bunch of water flows into the lake, and a bunch of water flows out. The streams that feed the lake dump 5,000 cubic meters of water in every day, and the lake feeds a river that carries off 5,000 cubic meters of water out every day. And if we assume that the lake water is always mixed, that all of the water in the lake has the same concentration of toxic stuff, how much waste will be left in the lake after a month? After all, the authorities, they close the lake to fishing and boating and stuff like that. When the accident happened, they want to know, when is it safe to reopen the lake? So we're going to set this up as a differential equation. We'll let y be the amount of waste that's in the lake. So at time zero, that's 10 tons. And we'll let t be time. And we have to figure out at what rate is the toxic waste being flushed out of the lake. So the rate at which the amount of toxic stuff is changing is the rate at which the toxic stuff is flowing into the lake minus the rate at which it's flowing out. Now, in this example, there's nothing flowing in. The only thing that's flowing into the lake is clean water. The toxic waste was dumped there once in an accident and doesn't continue to get dumped. We have to figure out at what rate is the stuff flowing out. Well, we know that every day 5,000 cubic meters of water flows out. Now, how much industrial waste is included in that 5,000? Cubic meters. Well, we have to figure out the concentration of waste. So if there's an amount y of toxic stuff and it's diluted among 50,000 meters, the concentration is y divided by 50,000. We multiply that by the 5,000 cubic meters per day that is flowing out, and we get that the amount that the outflow of toxic stuff is y over 10, and that's in tons per day if we're keeping track of units. Now, it's 0 minus y over 10, so our differential equation is dy dt equals minus y over 10. So now, we've done the work of talking our way through the word problem, and we've turned the word problem into a differential equation. The next step is to solve the differential equation. So we've got dy dt equals minus y over 10, and we cross multiply, and we get dy equals minus dt over 10. And we integrate, and we get the log of y is minus t over 10 plus a constant. We've seen this before. We've seen that this means that y is e to the minus t over 10 times e to the constant. And that means that y is plus or minus e to the constant e to the minus t over 10. And we give the plus or minus e to the constant a name. We call that a. And so our solution is a times e to the minus 10 t over 10, where a is an arbitrary constant. Of course, it's not completely arbitrary because we know how much stuff there was at time zero. At time zero, we had 10 tons of waste. By our formula, that has to be a e to the minus zero, which is a. So now we know that a is 10 tons. So if you want to know how much stuff there is at time t, the amount of toxic waste at time t is 10 e to the minus t over 10. So the Parks Authority was wondering, is it safe to reopen the lake after a month? So after 30 days, you plug in t equals 30 and you get 10 e to the minus 30 over 10. So that's 10 e to the minus 3. And you discover that we're down to 0.4987 tons. We start off with 10 tons, and after a month, 19/20 of it has been washed away, and we're left with half a ton. After another 30 days, we're down to 10 e to the minus 6, which is a 20th of that. We're down to a 40th of a ton, or about 50 pounds. After another month, we're 10 e to the minus 9th, which is a 20th of that, is 2.5 pounds. Another month, and we're a 20th of that, that's about 2 ounces. Another month, we're a 20th of that, and we're down to 3 grams. And obviously, when to open the lake depends on just how toxic the waste was. If it's plutonium, you got to still keep it closed. If it's mild toxic waste, you could probably open it sometime in here. It's a big lake. Okay? So the things to notice about this problem are talking your way through the actual ecology of the situation to figure out what a differential equation is. Once you have the differential equation, by now you should recognize dy dt equals a constant times y has as a solution an exponential. And we're going to see more about that in the next video. And then the exponential, it doesn't lose a certain amount every month, it loses a certain fraction every month. Every month, you wind up with only a 20th of what you had the previous month. You cut it by a factor of 20 every month until you're down to a small enough amount that it's safe to reopen the park.